Hey, folks. How you doing? We've seen each other before. Well, no, that's not true. If you've seen me, I don't see you. Okay. Remember this guy. Yeah, so we did some work, and as always, I try to do the least with the most result. And, you know, we were convinced that this bridge saddle was crap. And we got a new one from the guys at Larvae. And also in the meantime, we talked about making it better as far as a plug-in. So we've gone and got one of these guys, the LR bags system, which works in two ways. There is a piezo that does go under the saddle, but this deals with the low end frequencies, I believe. I'm going to read all about the thing again. And then this is the microphone that lives. I gotta check the drawing. I believe it lives here, just under the bridge saddle. We're gonna have another quick look just to be sure. And then that's the little preamp guy that goes in the sound hole. And they even make a little accommodation there for the brace and the guitar and all that. Yeah, so new LR bags pickup system, new bridge saddle, new strings, I think, too. Better go look. Just a little, I just plugged it in with what's living in it. Yeah, let's take some parts off it and
yeah, okay, see what's so going.
The first step is to get rid of the old stuff. Conveniently enough, this guitar already had a battery in it, and it already had a end pin installation. So that'll excuse me, cut down on a couple of steps. Looking for tools. Is this the one? I think it is. Maybe not. Sure it is. I need a thing here, boys and girls. I'm hoping I can spin it with my fingers by now. That guy. Okay, back in a minute. And what we have is a Fishman. You know, just a suggestion. Maybe you want to put that on Kijiji and sell it to somebody and recoup some of the cost of the new system. This ain't working out. What did they do here? Interesting. Very interesting. I digress. So to release this guy, we need to desolder inside the little preamp, because that hole don't work. And that's the guy that's going in there in a minute. What else is dicky about this? No, nothing's ever easy, guys. I even said that too, you know. You know, man, I'll just do this. No problem. It'll be a few minutes. And everything's going to be great. And, you know. No, I'll be an hour and a half fucking around with this. Oh, let's try that new bridge saddle. What's it going to do? Is it going to be the right piece? Oh, look at that. Those guys are so good. It saved me a lot of screwing about. So this will get a little fiddly. That's got to come up from underneath, because they have that at the end. So, you know, a leisurely Sunday afternoon, and I'm going to just like spend an hour and put this in. Nope. Okay. Working backwards in the mirror. Where is the hole? There is the hole. Come on. Nope. You guys want to watch me do this for the next half an hour. Oh, you dirty dog. I don't like these tweezers too much, but I really don't want to clamp anything on it. Okay, next. Excellent. Another camera fail. Battery fail. You missed all my struggles. Anyway, the end pin is in. We had to enlargulate that opening because the other one wasn't big enough. What else happened? Oh, we had to desolder the previous piezo, and then there was a lot of swearing threading that new piezo through the hole. But now we're at that point in the game where we're going to plant that. Everything's plugged in. I sort of started shaving the bridge saddle down a bit because I know it's going to have to be shaved down. But here's where I'm at, guys. I'm a little disappointed today, okay? Like, just this brand new bridge saddle came right from Larivee, alright? And that's how it fits. Like, there was, I figured for sure I'm going to have to size it a little bit. Like, it's going to, nope. We'll just cut it like that. So, anyway, that's what I know. I'm installing it because that's what I have. Okay, come on, get in there. Oh no, he gooched it. No, I didn't. All right. Yeah. Sorry, Lou, your old 9-volt doesn't do 9 volts. You owe me. Well, it works. The blend, so that, I think that makes it the pickup or the microphone, and that this would be the pickup. What's that one button do? Oh, that's in and out of phase, I believe. And what's that little guy do? Supposed to be a battery check thing here, but my big ass fingers can't fit in there and push that. And what's that guy? I gotta look at the manual. Interesting. Well, I just gotta get this bridge saddle into shape here and we'll be in business. Saddle boy. Oh, just that, just so you know, that's a big flat piece of aluminum under there. Oh no, oh, that hurt. Oh look, there's skin on the sandpaper. Are we having fun yet? Always important to flip it. But I do have markings on there, guys, so it's not like I'm actually not even close. I have to suck the dust off my sandpaper. But I am disappointed with how that saddle fits in there. Right from those guys, too. It's like, you frickin' frickers. And, the ideal rule with this sort of crap too is that the bridge saddle, ideally it should, you'd want 50-50, right? Half as much in the slot as is sticking out of it, wherever that takes you, right? And I think we're there, but I just don't like the way it sits. It wants to tilt over because it's so sloppy in there. It seems like a lot of movement to me. Anyhow, this is also one of those jobs when your hand's all in there. If you know a small person who's articulate enough, get their assistance. We're getting close. I can tell my fingers are getting close to the sandpaper. No, not like that. Oh, there we go. Yeah, we're getting close. The shittiest part is going too far. Then you've gouged it. But like I said, we can calculate that. Take double off the saddle, which you want the string to drop by. Thereabouts. Come on. Yeah. So, the gods of calculation have served me well. We will have achieved proper string height. And as before, this guitar was here before you guys saw it. Like I said, we sort of went at it in increments. We knew that the bridge saddle that was on it wasn't great, and I'm not overly sold on this one either. So, but then through other conversation, we talked about the installation of the new electronic system, which, regardless of everything, is very pleasing. Those guys came up with some great stuff. And you know what? I really apologize, Lou. I haven't put new strings on it yet, but I knew I'd be pulling them on and off a whole bunch of times to get this bridge saddle right. I need a little more length on that guy. So, hence I'm sort of just testing and dicking around with the old strings, which don't want to cooperate, and my old hands don't want to cooperate. I just need more string off that one. Come to me, fishy fishy. Yeah, something like that. But you know, if you're a gigging guy with an acoustic guitar, these systems are pretty good. There's a lot of audio, like sound bite stuff on the web. If you want to hear what they sound live and in the studio and all that great stuff. Okay, let me tune it up to bitch and we'll be right back. Well, it still needs to come down a hair. So, math failed me, but at least it didn't fail me in the opposite direction I needed to go. I could have been just too chicken shit with my pencil line too. So, another 64, which means a 32. 64 there, or 32 off of there, which is a couple of those. Alright then, we're fun, here we go. Get to come back and work on the movie and the... Bah! battery dies again. Oh, well. Run her into the dirt. Just, you know, just like a V8 engine with no oil. Okay, where was we? We was tweaking this bridge saddle. Like I said, it's always an adventure. Now you can see how I see. I got one of these on either side of my eyes. Most importantly, not to go over. Okay, so we want another 64th off there, at least, which is a 32 down here, and we'll make it so. And this time around, we'll put the new strings on. See how I roll? I gotta put the new strings on and jacked them and twisted them and kinked them right at the beginning, but I didn't do it. Once again, we'll give you a little cleaning. I haven't shaved my bum hole yet. I mean, my bridge saddle. I'm sure there's some viewers that, you know all about that. Based on the comments, I can sort of tell. It gives you an indication as to what you're actually dealing with. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but, you know. Okay. Damn it. Okay, a little more shaving of my saddle. So, it's gonna be that much, including the pencil line. See how much fun this is? You just tinker along and don't get excited. And always remember, you're never going to make any money doing this. Because he fucked up his guitar. No one is going to love him anymore. The girls won't like him. His intonation sucks. Well, no, his intonation sucks. Hopefully his girlfriend sucks. It's the only hope you have in the world. I'm under the impression I'm getting close. But like I said, always remember, keep spinning it around. Okay, I quit. New string. Oh, this thing died. Well, all we can say is it's as good as it can ever be. But that pickup just sounds, well, it's two things. It's a microphone and a piezo combined in a preamp. So natural sounding, it's just good work. I believe that's the mic, yeah. You can hear it. This would be the piezo. Blend the two. Jesus, sounds nice. I'm sure it would record very well. And I think I still hear a little sitar-y. Ah, I don't know, guys. I install the parts. I read the brochures. I watch the forums. And at the end of it all, I just can't rebuild the guitar from the ground up. That's what I know. Cheers, folks.